Hi everyone, I will talk about my work at Distributed Computing Perspective of Unconditionally Secure Information Transmission in Russian Card Problems. Peter Winkler in The Bridge magazine in 1981 showed how one player could send her partner information about her hand undecipherable to the opponents, even though the protocol was known to them. Later on, in a sequence of papers by Fisher, Patterson, Rakoff, Wright, and others, extended these ideas to obtain protocols for secret bit and key exchange. For example, one of the early papers by Fisher and Wright was published in the Journal of Cryptology in 1996. And then the idea of using correlated inputs in the presence of computationally unbounded adversary is because actually the correlated inputs are needed for security in this setting. And cards are an elegant way of representing correlated initial local variables for the players. Later on, in the Moscow Mathematics Olympiad of 2000, was presented what was later called the Russian cards problem, consisting of a deck of seven cards, 0, 1, 2, through all the way up to card number 6. Each of Alice and Bob are given 3 cards. For example, Alice can be given the cards 0, 1, and 2, and Bob could get the cards 3, 4, and 5. And then Kat gets the remaining card out of the 7 cards. In this example, Kat would get card number 6. And the goal is for Alice and Bob to learn each other cards using public announcements, while Kat should not learn the location of any single card. In spite of Alice knowing the protocol that Alice and Bob are using to communicate with each other. The classic solution for the Russian cards problem consists of 2 steps. First, Alice announces the sum of her cards modulo 7. In this case, she would announce 0 plus 1 plus 2 modulo 7. She would announce 3. From this announcement and his own hand, Bob can deduce, using a little bit of number theory, what is the hand of Alice. And then once Bob knows both his hand and the hand of Alice, then Bob can respond with the remaining card, the card number 6 in this example, which is a card Kat already knows because it's her own card. So Kat learned nothing from the conversation, while Alice and Bob have succeeded in exchanging each other's cards. Hans van Dietmarsch generalized this problem and started a research line on the generalized Russian card problems, where the deck consists of n cards. There is a signature ABC that determines how many cards Alice gets, how many cards Bob gets, and how many cards Kat gets. With the same goal, Alice and Bob should learn each other cards using public announcements, while Kat should not learn the location of any single card. Mostly two-step protocols have been studied in this setting. Actually, quite a few papers that have used either combinatorial designs or epistemic logic, and even stronger versions have been studied where Kat should know anything at all after the conversation of Alice and Bob. So the idea is in the generalized Russian card problems that has been widely studied, these two-step protocols exactly as before, where Alice now uses a deterministic protocol P to decide which message she will announce based on her cards. Alice announces the message PA, base of her hand, from which Bob should be able to learn all the cards of Alice, and then Bob can respond with the cards that neither Alice nor Bob have, which from which Alice should be able to learn the hand of B, and Kat learns no location of a single card after the conversation. So the question is given a signature IBC for a deck of N cards. The question that has been studied is for what signatures, trying to characterize for what signatures there exist at the protocol. And for the case where Kat gets a single card, there are solutions that announce, by which Alice announces her cards modulo an appropriate prime number greater or equal than n. And for the general case where Kat can get more than one card, only special cases have been described. So the first goal of the paper is to extend these results and try to extend the characterization of when there exists a solution, but also we propose to study three new aspects of this problem. The first one is studying the communication complexity of the problem, how many bits Alice has to send over in order that B learns her cards. Then we introduce the new notion of minimally informative protocol, where we simply want that the protocol is not trivial. That means that Bob should learn something about the hand of Alice. And finally, we introduce what seemed initially a simple generalization, but turns out to be quite interesting, is to allow the possibility that R cards out of the N cards are dealt to no one. That means N is equal to A plus B plus C plus R. Alice gets A cards, Bob gets B cards, CC, and the remainder are not dealt to anyone. Through a new perspective inspired by distributed computing, based strongly on Johnson graphs, I will explain how. And it turns out that this perspective facilitates using coding theory and additive theory, number theory techniques. So in this new perspective, we can represent correlated inputs by combinatorial structures. For example, here where you have four cards, one is dealt to Alice, one to Bob, and one to Kat. If you consider all the possible ways of dealing the cards and represent each one by a triangle, then you can see that actually what you obtain is a subdivided torus. You can see in the figure in this example where Alice gets card three and Bob gets card one. These two inputs consist of an edge, which is contained on two different triangles, depending on whether the input of CAD is zero or is two. And this is exactly one different with the standard model using communication complexity, where the inputs are not correlated and any combination of inputs are usually assumed. So what we have is that we can view the protocol of Olofali simply as a coloring of the vertices associated to her possible hands. The possible hands of Alice are simply all subsets of size A of a set of size N, which is the deck of the cards. Then we have the possible messages that Alice might send. And then a protocol is a coloring from the vertices, from the possible all subsets of size A to the possible messages. And then we want to study properties that this coloring should satisfy to be either informative or minimally informative and safe. And this is done by considering the indistinguishability graphs for both denoted GB and for CATH GSD on the same set of vertices of the set of possible hands of Alice. For Bob, what we want to represent in this graph is that two vertices of Alice, A and E, should be adjacent in this graph if and only if B considers them possible for some input B, namely, if there are input configurations A, B and A prime, B that are possible in the set of possible inputs. So in the figure on the right, we have a vertex of Bob, that when Bob has card one, and Bob considers possible three hands of Alice when Alice has input zero, where Alice has input two, or where Alice input three, and these three vertices are joined by edges. And similarly, we can define the indistinguishability graph for CAD, where when CAD has some input in the figure has input one, CAD considers possible that Alice has any of the three hands, well, when she has zero, two, or three. And it turns out that these indistinguishability graphs are actually the distant Johnson graphs. The vertices of the graph, as we said, are all possible subset of a set of size n. Subsets are of size A. And two edges, there will be an edge between two vertices precisely when the intersection of the two core sets is greater or equal to A minus D. So this is the distant Johnson graph, which when D equal to one is the classic Johnson graph that has been thoroughly studied. And here we can see a few examples. For example, on the right, we have the Johnson graph for a set of size five and all subsets of size two. The vertices are all subsets of size two. And you connect with an edge two exactly when they intersect in one card, in one. Interestingly, the cliques of Johnson graphs have been studied, and here exactly represent the situation where, given a hand B of Bob, the clique is formed by all possible hands of Alice that he considers possible in the Johnson graph of distance C plus R. And similarly for CAD, and the maximal cliques of Johnson graphs have been thoroughly studied, for example, in this book by Godzilla and Meager, but in other contexts also. And much is known about the structure of these cliques and their sizes. So given this basic way of representing the problem through Johnson graphs and their maximal cliques, now we want to discuss what are the protocols that the color protocol should satisfy to be informative, minimal informative, and safe. To be informative, what we want is that every vertex of each one of these cliques is colored with a different color, because this is exactly what is needed for Bob to be able to distinguish two hands of Alice's after hearing a message M. The protocol will be minimally informative if at least two vertices of each click are not colored equally. Otherwise, if all colors are colored equally, then of course Bob learns nothing after hearing M. Bob would know in advance what would be the message that Alice was going to send. And finally, the protocol is safe if there are two vertices of each click that are colored equally for each possible card that either Alice may have or may not have. That means that when Kat hears the announcement of Alice, there will be at least two hands that Kat will be not be able to distinguish one where Alice has a card and one when she doesn't have the card. So simply, an informative protocol is simply a proper vertex coloring of the distance C plus R Johnson graph. And for the other cases are these new notions of minimal coloring or safe coloring of the Johnson graph. So the communication complexity of an informative protocol, the number of bits needed, will be simply determined by the chromatic number of the distance D Johnson graph. And additionally, if the protocol is safe, the coloring should satisfy the additional properties of not being a proper coloring of the distance B plus R Johnson graph. However, even the chromatic number of a Johnson graph, even for the case where C plus R equal to one is an open problem that has been studied in coding theory, in graph theory, in combinatorics of intersecting sets. In the book of Godzilla and Meager, there's a whole section describing the problems opening determining the chromatic number of Johnson graph. And this is just for the case of C plus R equal to one, not much more for the general case of where C plus R may be greater than one. So yet we are able to adapt results from coding theory to show the asymptotic bit communication complexity of the D C plus R Johnson graph, where and show that the number of bits necessary and sufficient are C plus R times log n. For the case of much simpler case of Johnson graph of D equal to one, where the number of cards then C plus R is equal to one, the number of bits is log n, provided that A times B. And this is achieved by the modulo n protocols. Actually, here the constant is one in the expression, theta expression. For minimally informative case, our main results is that when C plus R equal to one, minimally informative is equivalent actually to Bob learning one card of Alice. And in general, Bob learns that Alice has one of the cards in a set of size C plus R. And with respect to the characterization, we have several results. One of the main results is that one bit is sufficient for a minimal informative and safe protocol when C plus R equal to one, and we characterize for which cases that A should be greater than n over 2 minus 1 and B less than n over 2 by a protocol by which Alice sends the sum of her cards modulo 2. In particular, for the classic Russian problems, there is a one-bit minimal informative protocol, which is kind of interesting because it says that Alice and Bob with a single bit signal, that means Alice moving her head left or right, can transfer secretly one of her cards to Bob without Kath learning anything about the location of other cards. To conclude, for minimal informative transmission, we obtain a partial characterization of when there exist solutions for which signature. And there are many open problems. In this case, it would be interesting to study the minimally informative chromatic number of a graph and the more refined version that requires the coloring to also be safe. to prove lower bounds on the bit communication complexity for minimally information transmission. For the case of informative protocols, not necessarily said, we have seen that it is equivalent to finding the chromatic number of the C plus R distance Johnson graph, which is an important probe question already for the case of C plus R equal to 1. Here there are several references that you can see in the paper, but this is one of the classic papers by Brouwer and Etzion, where they study distance for constant weight colorings, and which are closely related to the chromatic number of Johnson graphs, but has been studied also in other contexts like quantum probability and combinatorics. For when we want the protocol to not to be informative and also safe, then it is equivalent to find a proper and safe coloring of the Johnson graph, which is open in general, but much better understood for the case of C plus R. And there are many additional open problems to study, consider stronger security requirements, where nothing will be learned by Kath about even combinations of cards that Alice may hold. There is a sequence of papers by Swanson and Stinson and others. Then there is the other research line by mainly Van Dietmars that has studied the problem via epistemic logic, what agents know about each other, but not for the minimal informative case, nor for the case so far greater than zero. And of course, it would be nice to consider multi-round protocols, multi-party protocols, randomize, and so on. Thanks for your attention.